Hi everyone, I am Nena. I'm a Dubai-based recruitment consultant, a career blogger. Also, I have worked as an HR professional. In today's video, I'm going to tell you the do's and don'ts of an exit interview. So stay tuned. Exit interviews are the most tricky parts of any transition phase. Now finally, the moment has come which you've been waiting for. Changing your job and switching to a better career opportunity. But there is a process in between which is a bit tricky. And if not handled properly, it could create a lot of problems in the future. So there are certain things that you must do during exit from your current workplace. And there are certain things which you must not do at all while you're leaving. So exit interviews have to be managed very cautiously. There are certain do's and don'ts of an exit interview. So today in this video, I'm going to talk about the do's first. So what you must do once you receive an offer? The first thing that comes to your mind is putting up a resignation. Your resignation have to be in person. Don't just send an email or just prepare a document to share it with your boss that you're leaving the company. This is very unprofessional. Be remembered about your credibility and your professionalism. Leave any organization professionally. Meet your boss, inform them in person that you are going to leave, you have another offer in hand, and followed by that, do send a document. You got the offer that you wanted, you are looking forward for your career growth. You have all the right reasons to be very professional while leaving and create a good impression on your colleagues who would be your ex-colleagues very soon. So always leave in good terms, whether it's your boss, whether it's your co-workers, anybody who you have known closely and worked with. You should create a good impression while you are in the transition phase. Now, the second thing that comes to your mind after putting up your resignation through your boss is the notice period. Always discuss with your boss about the notice period. Generally, contracts do have them mentioned that how much would be your notice period. Whatever your contract says, or if it doesn't say anything, always ask your boss that if he needs you to serve notice. 2 weeks is an ideal time. I've also made a video about transitions. Check it in the description box. You will get to learn a lot about transitions from that video. Now, since you have decided to put your papers, either your exit interview will happen immediately or at the end of your notice period. If it's happening immediately, be very general about reason for leaving. You need not to tell your boss where you are joining. You are not obliged to do that. Understand, your resignation has come as an unwelcome surprise to your boss. He has got extended responsibility of taking approvals for rehire. He has to find a replacement. So there might be some pending tasks which he would make his mind run about to complete in time. So it's an unwelcome surprise for any boss that his employee or his staff member is leaving. So be courteous in asking about any help that you may offer during your transition phase. You should always offer them that I am very much willing to extend if at all I'm required to. Though you have a written offer, you have no obligation to stay, but extra kindness would always make you remember as a good employee. So there is no harm in offering an extension if you can. Also offering any extra assistance during your transition phase to your boss. Some organizations, they, after getting the news that you're going to leave the company soon, they want you to leave immediately. It comes as a surprise to many employees because they don't expect this to happen. Be ready for it. When you're going to talk to your boss to resign, he or she may tell you to keep it confidential and leave immediately. Respect their decision. because they know how to manage a big team. That's why they are at the top. So if they take this decision that you should leave immediately, you should respect that and move out of your role immediately. They might have their reasons. They don't want the employees to know that where you're going. They don't want rumors to spread. They don't want employee morale to go down. So even if they tell you to leave immediately, it's for some strong reason. Or maybe you or your boss don't get along very well. In that case also, leaving immediately is a win-win situation for both of you. The last thread of your transition process is the exit interview. It may happen immediately once you tell your boss that you're going to put your papers, or it may have at the end of your notice period. Be ready to provide constructive feedback. When I say constructive feedback, do offer your suggestions about the policies, procedures, and certain functionalities. It may help your employer to improve them in the future. Now, all the don'ts we'll talk about. We'll talk about what you must not do during an exit interview. So, first and foremost thing, we'll again start with the resignation. No written resignation before talking to your boss. Make sure you give your resignation in person after a discussion. Second thing, don't be mean. Don't think you have an offer and you could immediately exit the company and never turn back. No, it doesn't happen this way. You have to be kind, you have to be generous in offering any help. Don't leave your work in between and leave. I understand you cannot give your time extensively on the projects you were working on, but make sure you give a proper handover to somebody who is going to take your place or somebody who is going to train another employee. Don't leave your work pending. It will put a question on your credibility. It will put a question on your professionalism. If you have decided to make a move, don't tell your colleagues before your boss. Your boss should be the first one to know. No matter how bad terms you have with him or her, they have the first right to know. They should not hear it from your co-workers or anybody else. You should be the first one to inform your boss. When it comes to exit interview, don't point fingers on anybody. Don't take names. You must avoid quoting anybody for any discrepancies in the system. It's a small professional world, very small industry. You may run into your ex-colleagues anywhere. So it doesn't leave a good impression if you are going to badmouth anybody during your exit interview, because it's your chance. It's not the right way to leave any organization. It happens sometimes that some employers ask you to keep your resignation to yourself. In this situation, it's very tricky to manage. If you are not ready to lie, you prefer to leave. Give your superiors an option that I cannot keep this news to myself for a prolonged period. I can keep it for some time, but later I would like to tell my colleagues and give them a proper handover. If they disagree with you, then I would suggest you ask them that in that case you'd like to leave the organization. Lastly, do not insult anybody. Do not insult your boss or insult the organization in front of anyone before you leave or even after leaving. This is not the right thing to do. This opportunity has come your way. You have learned, you have grown, you have enhanced your skills in this organization. So be respectful, show your gratitude, and thank everyone before leaving. I hope you liked all the do's and don'ts of this video, and they would certainly help you in having a smooth transition. Do subscribe to my YouTube channel for more career tips. I also write a career blog at outdoorswithnaina.com. I will leave a link of my other videos in the description box regarding transition. Do have a look at them and do share your feedback on my videos. If you like what I'm making, I would love to hear from you. Thank you for watching.